CUDA C++ is a pretty great way to get started, but obviously it comes with its own learning curve as well, right? And then you have different developer tools for debugging and profiling your GPU accelerated application. And on the right side are another set of important things, you know, which are the drivers, right? Which is used for memory management, for Windows and graphics, and for communication library. So these are the fundamental CUDA platforms, on top of which people basically build these CUDAX libraries for their target applications, right? And obviously, you know, all of this, right, software stack can be used on various hardware devices, various operating systems. And when you go into deployment, you will need a lot of different toolkits like containers, orchestration, different packaging tools like RPM and others, GPU management and monitoring, right, as well as the I/O and the storage capabilities as well, accelerated I/O and storage capability as well. So again, as I was referring to that, accelerated computing is not just an hardware engineering problem. It is a complete full stack hardware engineering plus system software engineering plus plus the infrastructure engineering, which is the compiler part. It's that entire full stack problem statement that we are essentially trying to build on top of, right? Now, let's come to in context of accelerated data science for more visibility into what I'm trying to talk about, right? And what I the picture that you see here is basically a very comprehensive view, right? And there are only few key takeaways that I want you to take from these pictures, right? Obviously, on the bottom most is the underlying hardware. And again, it can be in form of workstation, data center, or even an edge device. Now, what we have also done is we have built a suite called the Magnum IO, which is for GPU accelerated storage, right? That means how can I accelerate my communication? That means how can I fetch the data directly from storage rather than, you know, going via the CPU route, right? Which again becomes a bottleneck. That means how can I essentially directly, you know, access the memory of the storage right from my GPU, which we also sometimes call it as GPU direct technology. So there is an entire layer of innovations happening only around the improvement in the IO, which we call it as the Magnum IO stack for better GPU to storage communications. Then we had the CUDAX set of libraries that I talked about, right? And the ones which are more relevant to us for data sciences, QDF, QML, QGraph and others. Now, on top of the CUDAX libraries, obviously you have different data processing blocks like Spark, right? And I'll talk about Spark a little later because that would just add more complexity. But just think of it like this, right? Spark is basically is one of the oldest and one of the widely most recognized in-memory computing framework that has been used by a lot of companies. But what has happened is now, you know, 6 months before, Spark was generally used only for doing in-memory computing on CPUs. But today, we have also built support for moving these Spark workloads on top of the GPUs, right? Now, on top of this layer, you also have things like Dask, which is basically used to basically take your data frames, which might be huge in size, and spread it across multiple GPUs and multiple nodes, right? Because say, for example, you want to process a data of couple of gigabytes, right? Say maybe 100 gigabytes. You cannot load that entire thing on top of one single GPU, right? That means you need to have and distributed you know, framework that can essentially take that large scale data frame and spread it across all the different GPUs that you have. Yeah. So Dask will help you to, you know, take your data and spread that across multiple GPUs and even across multiple nodes. Then you have the deep learning part, which I won't talk today. On top of this, we have the entire RAPIDS ecosystem, which I talked about, right? And we'll go into much more detail about Rapids in the upcoming slides. And then all the deployment part can happen via different schedulers and different frameworks like Dockers as well, which I'll talk in the upcoming slides. So as I talked about GPU direct storage, right? That means rather than going via the CPU route, right? Can I basically now directly access the storage from my GPU from my GPU itself? That means can my GPU directly access some of the data that is directly sitting on storage? And the answer to that question is yes, using the GPU direct storage technology. Now with that, let me move to the computing architecture, which is again talking about more fundamentals on how things basically get dispatched on top of GPUs.